So welcome everyone to the EPG Pathshala for the subject Information Technology for the paper Open Source Software for the module GNU Compiler Collection. So today's learning objectives are introduction, what is compiler, we shall understand what is compiler, what is GNU C compiler, how to compile a particular program, how to compile single program, how to compile multiple programs, and how to involve header files in the compilation process. So now let us understand what is compiler. So whatever programs written by the programmer are human readable or human understandable programs. The programs are not understandable by the computer, by the microprocessor. So it is required to convert or transform the human readable code into machine understandable executable code. So that particular process, conversion or transformation of human readable code into machine executable code, that process is called compilation. And the software, the particular software which converts or transforms this particular human readable code into executable code is called compiler software. Generally, it is called only compiler. It is known as only compiler. So what is GNU C compiler? So compiler is a computer program or a set of programs that transforms source code written in programming language, that is source language, into machine executable language, that is called object code. So what is GCC? There are several compilers available in the market. Among those compilers, GCC is a GNU compiler collection. So GNU compiler collection, a compiler system produced by GNU project, supports various programming languages such as C, C++, Objective-C, etc. It supports ANSI standards also. Earlier, it was known as GNU C compiler, that is GCC. So GCC is known as sometimes it is known as GNU C compiler, and nowadays it is known as GNU compiler collection. So it is a compiler designed to support multiple programming languages, adopted as a standard compiler for Unix and Linux family operating systems. It includes compilers for C, C++, Objective-C, and host of other languages. It is used to convert source code into machine executable object code. So GNU C compiler, that is GCC, is used to compile C programs, whereas GNU C++ compiler, that is called G++, that is used to compile C++ programs on Unix and Linux platforms. So next point is, what does GCC actually do? So GCC performs all of the following tasks, such as pre-processing, compilation, assembly, and linking. So now let us see how to compile a simple C program. So let us say this is our simple C program. First of all, open the VI editor and edit your simple1.c file, such as hash include stdio.h, main function containing welcome message to Dennis Ritchie sir. Now how to compile? So for that, GCC command is there, GCC, and the file name which you want to compile. See the output over here. So vi simple1.ccc, I have edited my program in the simple1.cc file in VI editor. Then I have invoked GCC compiler on the simple1.c. But right now you see in the code, the compiler detects that there is a semicolon missing. Here, semicolon is missing here, you see. So the GCC compiler will not compile, and it will simply throw an error, or it will display the error on this screen, such as simple1.c on line number 6, error is shown, expected semicolon before bracket. So now again open the file vi simple1.c, provide here semicolon, and again issue the same command GCC simple1.c. It will generate by default a.out file. a.out file will be generated, which will contain the actual object code, which is understandable, which is executable by the machine, by the microprocessor. So we can see in the output, successful compilation results into an output object file called a.out, and the a.out file can be executed in this manner. We can see in the screenshot gcc simple1.c, and now I am calling a.out. It will show me the program output, respected Dennis Ritchie sir. So this is how a simple C program is compiled and executed. Now let us see how to compile a simple C++ program. Having understood this how to compilation process for C program, now let us understand compilation process for simple C++ program. So again, let us open the VI editor and edit the program simple2.cc file. So vi simple2.cc hash include stdio.h, or you can go for iostream header, integer main, printf. So having understood the compilation process for C program, now let us understand, now let us see how C++ program should be compiled. So first of all, open the vi editor, edit your program, say simple2.cc file, edit your program, and then initiate the compilation process. So vi simple2.cc file hash include iostream, if required you can include using namespace std also, main function, welcome the jarn startup sir also sir, afari kariye apna afari kariye. So now let us understand the compilation process for simple C++ program. So open the vi editor and edit your simple2.cc file, say hash include iostream, if required you can include using namespace std, main function, respected jarn startup sir, cout. Now there is a g++ command for compilation of C++ files. For C files there is a gcc command, for C++ file programs there is a g++ command. So simply again g++ and provide the file name, the C++ source code file name which is required to be compiled. So g++ simple2.cc file, it could be .cpp file, it could be .c capital C file, whatever. So successful compilation results into an output object file called a.out, as we can see in the output also here on the screen, say a.out. So this is the executable format, executable file of simple2.cc file. It is executed in the same way, say current directory, and provide the name of the executable file name and hit enter key. So it will provide, the program will be executed and output will be displayed on the screen. So friends, this is how a C++ program is compiled. So again remember G++ command, and now let us always, if we do not provide the output file, it will always, the compiler will always generate the a.out file for machine executable code. So if we want, what if we want to provide our own executable file, so for that provide the minus o option with the g++ command, g++ your source file, and provide the minus o switch or minus o option, and provide the output file. This file, particular file, after successful compilation will contain the executable code. So successful compilation results into an output object file such as simple2.exe. Remember, in C++ and in C, as far as GNU is concerned, the file name is not important, but here for sake of understanding I am providing the .exe extension over here. So again, the same particular file can be executed in this way. So current directory, provide the path, the current directory and the executable file name, so simple2.exe. So we can see here now simple2.exe is generated, and it is executed in the same way as we did, as we executed earlier a.out file. So now let us understand how to include or how to consider header files also at the time of compilation. So let us understand this particular process using a very simple example. Now let us see how to use header file. So I have created here two files, source file and the header file. The source file is a useheader.c file and the header file is a header.h. In the source file, I have included hash included header1.h. On line number 2, we can see hash include header1.h. It contains some function. Some function is defined in the header1.h file, which is shown over here. Some function definition, the function body is shown in the header1.h header file. And this header1.h file is included in the source file useheader.c file. So this is the source code. Now let us see how to compile. The compilation is very straightforward as both the files are in the same directory, are in the common directory. So there is no special any other option required here. See here, first of all we edited useheader.c file, then header1.h file. Now let us compile the C file, gcc useheader.c minus o, that is the output file name, that is useheader.exe. Useheader.exe is successfully compiled, useheader.exe is generated successfully and we can execute it. So main function calling some function, then some function entered in some function, now some function exiting some function, and again the control went back to the main function, came back from some function. So this is how the header files are included. Remember here, note here that the source file and the header file are in the same directory. Now let us see how to use the header files which are available in the different directory other than the source directory, other than the directory in which the source file is existing. So let us see the example. So source file is vi use header from different directory.c. So here again, hash include header2.h. Remember here, header2.h file exists, is defined in some different directory. The use header from different directory.c and header2.h exist in two different directories. The program is same as the earlier one. Printf main function, main calling some function 2, some function 2. The sum function 2 is defined in the header2.h file. And the ordinary simple normal code, main came back from sum function. Now let us see the header2.h. The header2.h is shown over here. Hash include stdio.h, sum function 2. The function prints 2 output messages only. Now let us see how to compile. So gcc use header from different directory.c minus o use header from different directory.exe, that is the output file name. Now additional option required here is minus I and the directory where your header file is existing. So minus I stands for include directory path, and the header directory I have defined in the current directory where the use header from different directory.c file is defined. So in the current directory I have defined the header directory. So this particular option is important when the included header file is defined in some different directory. So in case of no errors, the executable file will be successfully created and we can execute the executable file in normal way, in ordinary way. So this particular minus I option instructs the GCC to look for hash includes in this particular path header directory in addition to other directories you specify with minus I option. Now friends, GNU C compiler is smart enough at the time of compilation, it generates a certain warnings. Some warnings are are compatible with the underlying platform, so they will not be treated as errors. So such warnings are just treated as warnings, and the program will be the GNU compiler will allow program compilation. But however, the programmer if would like to see ki what errors are, what warnings are generated, then the programmer can see, can view the list of all warnings generated by the compiler, GNU C compiler. Now let us see how to generate, how to print all those warnings. So there is a minus W all option. Sometimes it is also pronounced as a minus wall option, but it stands for write. W stands for write warnings. Write warnings, and which type of warnings? Then all warnings. So there is option called minus W all. Option is used to display various compile time warnings, such as uninitialized warning variables, unused variables, defaulting return types, missing parentheses in some ambiguous context. So it is advised to always use minus wall options to get to know about such warnings and resolve them. Now let us understand this using some program. So this is simple program. Print warnings dot c file it is. There is a uninitialized variable called n. See, the variable is declared, but it is not assigned some specific value. And without assigning some value, the program is trying to print the value of the variable n. In normal course, it is okay. The program should compile and it should print some garbage value. But here the programmer wants to restrict that the garbage values should not be treated, should not be entertained. So how to print all the warnings? So here see, GCC minus capital W, see W is capital, minus capital W all print warnings dot C and provide the output executable file name. So now see, the compiler will not generate the out executable file. Instead, the compiler will provide the all warnings. Warning is printed here. N is used uninitialized in this function. So now, what the programmer is required to do? Program is required to again edit the file and make the corrections and recompile the file. Now friends, the compilation process involves certain stages. The first stage is pre-processing. So suppose a programmer wants to see whatever pre-processor directives or pre-processor output. So now let us see how to see or how to view the pre-processor output generated by the compiler, GNU C compiler. So produce only pre-processor output. Very simple program, very simple file, the same file we shall be discussing. Include stdio.h, main function, integer n, the variable is declared here, not initialized, and the program is printing the value of n. The file name is tmp.c. Now let us see how to generate or how to print the preprocessor output generated by the GCC compiler. So for that, use minus e option. Remember, E should be capital. Use minus capital E option. So GCC minus capital E TMP dot C. So what it will do? It produces preprocessor directives output on screen. So by default, the minus E option will print the preprocessor directives output on the screen. Instead, if you want to direct the output on in some file, then provide the redirection on the command line, say greater than symbol and tmp dot I. So it will redirect preprocessor directives output to some file. During compilation, before linking happens, assembly code is generated. If the programmer wants to see the assembly code, let us see how to generate the assembly code. So produce only assembly code, the same program. Now how so for that, minus S, minus capital S option is used. So GCC minus capital S TMP dot C. So it produces assembly code in TMP dot S file. Here it is not required to provide minus O option. By default, the compiler will generate, will create the TMP, the file name dot small s, such a file name will be created, and the assembly code will be redirected in the tmp.s file. So the generated assembly code can be seen. Now let us see how to produce a compiled code without linking. So for that, use minus capital C option. So GCC minus capital C tmp.c and output file name. So it should be tmp.o. So what it will do, it produces compiled code in a file tmp.o. It doesn't link the all files with the library functions. Now in a single command, if you want to produce all intermediate files, so for that use minus GCC minus save temps option, GCC save temps option, and provide the source file name tmp.c. As can be seen on the in the output, GCC minus save temps tmp.c. So it will generate the executable file also. Source file is there, the assembly code, the intermediate compiled code, and the preprocessor output. How to compile multi-file program? So let us say you have file1.c and file2.c. So file1.c contains call sum function, and the sum function is again defined in the file called file2.c. Now how to compile these two files? Let us see. So in the first command, I am giving GCC minus C file1.c into file1.o, GCC minus C file2.c, output file is my file2.o. Now generate the final executable file, GCC file1.o, file2.o, and provide the output file name. So here you can provide such multiple n number of files, say file1.o, file2.o, file3.o, file4.o, file n.o. Okay, it will generate the file.exe, the final executable file. And this is the output of the executable file name. So minus C option, GCC does compilation and assembly of the source files without linking. The output files are object code files, .o files. They can be later linked and form the executable file. Now let us see how to generate GDB friendly object file. So minus G option is used to produce GDB debugger friendly output file. It includes GDB friendly symbol table. It is very useful while working with GDB. So provide the minus G option, GCC minus G program1.c and output file name. So it will generate the symbol table in the program1.exe. So it will be helpful to the GDB debugger at the time of debugging process. Now let us see how to interpret the char data type as unsigned char. Sometimes we assign the negative values to the char data type. So char C is equal to minus 10. And let us print the value of the C variable. So the file name is unsigned char.c. Now let us compile it. GCC unsigned char.c into unsigned char.exe file. And it will print the minus 10 value. But sometimes if the programmer wants to forcefully treat the char data type as unsigned char only. So for that, additional switch is available with the GCC command. Minus F unsigned char. So F stands for the flag unsigned char. Right? In that case, the compiler will treat the char as a unsigned char, and minus 10 here, minus 10 will be treated as 246. Now let us see how to interpret char as a signed char. In that case, you have to provide here minus F unsigned char. Sometimes compile time macros become important. So how to involve or how to incorporate the compile time macros in the program? Let us understand with using some example, very simple example. In the main function, the my macro is tested. Whether the my macro is defined or not, let us test it. If defined, my macro, in that case the message will be displayed, my macro is defined, end of the condition. Now how to provide the macro at the time of compilation? So GCC command provide the minus d option. So minus d option is used to define some macro at the time of compilation. So here I have provided my macro, I have declared here my macro, and the source file name, output file name. In that case, as the macro is defined, when the program is executed, we will get the output my macro is defined. Whereas in the other case, see, the macro is not defined here at the time of compilation. In that case, we will not get the my macro is defined output. So use minus d option to define compile time macros in the code. GCC minus d my macro. Earlier we have seen minus val option. The minus val option with the GCC command prints all the warnings. Now suppose the program, now what if the programmer wants to forcefully instruct to the compiler to treat those warnings as errors? How to convert those warnings into forceful errors? Let us see it. So the same program, integer n, which is again uninitialized, so it will by default generate the warning. Earlier we have seen how to print all warnings at the time of compilation using minus val option. What if the programmer wants the compiler to generate, to convert those warnings into errors? So let us see it using example. So this is same example, the same program, the same source code, having a variable n which is uninitialized again, and before initializing or before assignment happens, the variable's value is printed on the screen. So the normal compilation, warning to error.c minus o warning to error.exe, executing the program will print the garbage value of n on the screen. Now let us convert all the warnings into errors. So along with the minus val option, provide the minus w error option also on the command line. So it will help the compiler to convert all the warnings into errors. So error is shown here and the program will not be compiled at all here. So GCC minus val minus w error warn.c. I have mentioned certain references in the notes. So in this session we have seen what is compilation, what is compiler, why compilation is required, what is GCC compiler, how to compile simple C program, how to compile C++ program, how to compile multiple source files, and various GCC options, how to print all warnings, how to convert warnings into error messages. So, thank you very much.